My first film was Targets, and I had learned. I worked on a film with Roger Corman first called The Wild Angels, and the editor of that film, Monty Hellman, didn't do a very good job with the footage that I shot. So I said to Roger, "It's all cut wrong." He said, "Well, then you fix it, you cut it." I said, "Well, I don't know how to cut." He said, "Well, go down, Dennis will show you how to do it." And so I went down to see Dennis, and Dennis showed me how to use the moviola and how to use the splicer. My sequences for The Wild Angels, and Roger put them in the picture, and that was it. So the next picture, that was the first picture I worked on, but I didn't direct it. I directed some of it. And then I did this picture, Targets, which Corman financed, and he didn't want to pay for a sound crew all the time, so we shot a lot of it, most of the action, actually, is silent. Then I hired Verna, who was at that point noted as a sound editor, and somebody's recommended her.
She put in all that sound. Everything in the freeway sequence was shot silent, and she put it in later. She had, I think, 28 to 30 tracks running at the same time. It was quite an elaborate job.
Hey, what are you doing? Hey!
Did an extraordinary job. Okay, here comes the last picture show, and she was doing something. She was doing it, shooting some government stuff. She wasn't available to do the sound or the picture, and so I again cut it myself, because Verna didn't actually cut any picture of mine until What's Up Doc. But I hired her for What's Up Doc, and she wasn't a picture cutter at that point. She was a sound editor.
In fact, Verna had edited several films, albeit of a slightly obscure nature, as far back as 1960, including The Wild Racers for Roger Corman, no doubt where the recommendation to Peter came from. She also cut the controversial political drama Medium Cool for cameraman-director Haskell Wexler in 1968, the same year as Targets. But back to Peter.
I hired her for Doc, and she did a good job. Now, the thing is, because I had cut my first two pictures myself, Wild Angels, I absolutely couldn't stand to have anybody cut the material any differently than I would cut it the first time. So I would mark it on the film. I would actually mark S for start, make a big C for cut, and take that frame out. So this worked for a while. And then Verna says to me, she says, "I don't know, I'm not doing anything." She says, you're cutting the picture. On Doc, she made some suggestion. We had a problem. I can't remember what the problem was now, but we had a problem. We couldn't fix it. And she came up with the solution. And I said, "See, you just earned your whole salary." And that's what happened on Daisy Miller, and it happened on, she always was able, every picture we did do together, she would have at least one suggestion that was great and that saved our ass. It's great to have her around. She was very encouraging and very, very good. Both on What's Up Doc and Paper Moon, I cut them myself. And but by the time we got to Daisy Miller, she was cutting it on her own.
Oh no, thank you. I like it ever so much more watching you drive around with it.
beautiful. Do get in and drive about with me.
That would be charming, but it's so fascinating, just as I am.
Well, it may be fascinating, my dear, but it's not the custom here.
Well, it ought to be then. If I didn't walk, I'd expire.
Well, you should walk with your mother, dear.
With my mother, dear? My mother never walked 10 steps in her life. And then, you know, I'm more than 5 years old.
Verna herself died too young at 64 in 1982. Her son Rick, now himself a lead editor, continued a family tradition by cutting 2 Peter Bogdanovich pictures, Illegally Yours and the Last Picture Show sequel, Texasville. Whether Peter continued to indicate S for start and C for cut, we have still to discover.